everyone, my name is WHYEXCEL, ExcelSifu from WHYEXCEL. In this video, we are going to see how we are able to use Excel to do banker calculation for the Monopoly game. Now what you can see on the right is the balance, what you can see on the left is the transaction details. If I type alpha player is paying to Charlie for the amount of 500, alpha 700 is expected to reduce, meanwhile Charlie was expected to increase. So I press enter, you can see this is done seamlessly. Step 1. In the blank worksheet, I key in the structure of the data I'm going to capture. On the left, I'll be showing the balance. The one on the right, I'll be showing the transaction details. So on the left, I type player and their balance. And meanwhile, the one on the right, I'll be typing the pay from and pay to for the amount of. To make the thing easier to see, I resize to increase the width of the column. Step 2. Key in the player name and do some formatting to make their name easier to see. I have three players. Their name are Alpha, Bravo, Charlie. After I'm done, I select three of them and I do the formatting inside home conditional formatting. Highlight cell rules equal to alpha and change the formatting to custom format. I will use fill to make it easy to read. I will use green color and press OK and OK. I will repeat the same step for the remaining two. It'll be something like home, conditional formatting, highlight cell rules equal to Bravo. And I want to change the format to orange background and press OK and OK. I will repeat the same for the third one, conditional formatting, highlight cell rules equals to Charlie, and I want to make it the background color to blue and press OK and OK. In the context, your player name might change. So you could go to home, conditional formatting, manage rules. Here you are able to see all the player name. You are able to edit them and change the color as you see is necessary. And press close without changing anything. At any beginning of the Monopoly game, all the players will have the same balance. So they will get the money of 1,005 from the banker. So I key in Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, and each of them will have 1,005. Instead of keying them one by one, I select the cell first. I key in 1,005. Instead of hitting Enter, I use Control Enter. So now of them is ready. Now this, we are setting up the player names, the color doesn't copy over. So I need to copy the formatting into the transaction site. So I select one of the cell on the left where we have done, Control C, because eventually we will have the name for the pay from and pay to. So I select two columns and I use pay special. The keyboard shortcut is Control Alternate V. Alternatively, I can go to home. On the far left side, you will see there's a paste. I click on the lower half, it says paste. There's one option, say paste special. Inside paste special, choose formats and OK. In future, any names enter in the D and E, the color will automatically appear. Step 3. We are going to set up the calculation for the balance. Whenever the name is same with the pay to, it will increase. When the name is same with the pay from, it will reduce. To get this thing done, we will be using some ifs. So I just in the first part equal sum ifs. When I see the wording is selected in the function, I use tab to auto-complete the function name with open parentheses. Sum from the amount, I select the entire column F, comma, whenever the pay to, I select the entire column, comma, same as the player name on the same row of the balance, then close parentheses. This is to increase. To reduce, I will use if minus, I will use minus sum ifs, tab the amount, comma, pay from, comma, and the name of the alpha. Close parentheses and press enter. I will get the value of 1005. I want to apply the same formula to the other players. So I go to the bottom right. I can see my mouse turn to black plus sign. This is called fill handle. I put double click and you will copy the formula towards the end. And double click. Now do some testing. Alpha is paying to buy a property. So alpha paying to banker, I leave it as blank. And you can notice after I key in alpha, the color changes. So alpha is paying 500 to buy a property. Then after a while, Bravo will buy a property for 300. Charlie will buy a property of 600. Then after a while, alpha need to pay rent to Bravo. So alpha pay from to Bravo for the value of 300. Enter. As I do all these things, you can notice the color changes and the values on this balance are automatically updated. After a while, if I continue, the transaction will be getting longer and longer. Now we are want to see how we are able to get this thing done to make sure it doesn't block out the view of the balance. Step 4. When the transaction getting longer and longer, it will block the view of the balance. Now we want to make sure the balance is always there for us to view whenever we are doing the data entry for the transaction. Now I select the column A and B. I control X, that means I'm going to cut it. I insert a new worksheet, the shortcut key will be Shift F11. I can click the plus sign on the bottom. I press Ctrl V to make it paste it to a new worksheet. So I may want to change the name of the new worksheet, says balance. And I want to zoom in to make it easier to see. In order to see two screens side by side, I will need to create a new window. First, I will go on view, new window. You'll notice something has opened with the same appearance. Now I want to arrange them side by side easily. I can go in view, arrange all vertical windows of active workbook. That means if I have other Excel workbook open at this moment, it will not interfere with our arrangement. If I press OK, you can see them appear side by side. On the right, I will see the balance. Meanwhile, on the left, I want to switch the view to the transaction view. Remove some of the blank columns so that it looks neater. And I want to increase the zoom so that I'm able to see all of them. That also means if any scrolling, any more transaction on the left side, the balance still stays there. This is how we are able to use Excel to do a banker calculation inside Monopoly game. If you like or benefiting from this video, please like and share to your friends and family colleagues so that they are able to benefit from the game of Monopoly with Excel. My name is WHYEXCEL, your Excel Sifu from WHYEXCEL.